This is Crash TV.
Welcome to another spectacular edition of Crash TV. It's episode 21, and I'm joined by Matt.
Hello.
And Craig.
Hello.
And this is a huge show because today, in the space of 10 short minutes, we're going to attempt to tell you about everything that's happening to the game across the 5th and 6th of February, which is only a few short weeks away.
Yeah.
And the first thing is the Burnout Paradise Ultimate Box will be released. That's a new box game which will be including all of the packs that we've released up until now, and the Party Pack, which is our first paid-for pack. It's available on Xbox and on Xbox 360, PlayStation 3, and for the first time ever, PC. The second thing is our Party Pack.
I was expecting a drum roll then.
We should have one, really, yeah. Shouldn't we? The second thing is the Party Pack, and that's available for the first time. It's our first paid-for content. And the third thing is a stack of free changes happening to the game. And I think, yeah, really, what we want to concentrate in today's show is the free stuff that's happening.
Crash TV Spotlight. Burnout Paradise.
On the 6th of Feb, I'm going to get the game. I'm thinking, brilliant, look at all this cool new free stuff that's happened. But I really fancy checking out Party because that's the thing I've been looking forward to. I'm really up for buying a bit of content, you know, seeing something new for the game. What's going to happen there?
Well, everyone's used to, you know, buying from, you know, Marketplace or the PlayStation Store, but we wanted to put a store right in the game. And it's just great because you can, you know, jump in. You know, I want to buy Party, I can get more details on it, I can see how cool it looks, I can go and buy it. It's really, really simple.
Yeah, you get a little preview of some of that stuff that's in there. So now if I want to buy the legendary cars, I can obviously get that they're available from the in-game store.
Yes.
But I can also look at them in the junkyards.
Yeah, so one thing that, obviously only when we've released them, but you'll be able to get them from the store or you'll be able to go to a junkyard and have a look around them and see how cool they look before you commit to a purchase.
So that's awesome, and now we want to talk about some of the free changes with Mr. Sullivan. So first up, we changed the car handling. I think that the forums, if we still have them, will go crazy. people will be saying, you can't change the handling.
We've improved.
So how's it changed?
We've improved what have the we car got? Handling. You know, we've been driving the cars for a long time, and one thing we wanted to do is introduce a lot more variety in the way that the vehicles handle. So at the lower end of the scale, you've got something like the Hunter Cavalry, which we've slowed down a little bit. It's slightly harder to crash the car. It's slightly more manageable, so it's become, you know, a far more kind of player-friendly car as the first car in the game. People have different tastes, and people want to drive in different styles and have different vehicles for different things that they do in the game. So if I'm playing Stunt Run, I want a slightly different vehicle than, say, if I'm in a race. So we've actually, you know, in making the cars more player-friendly, we've introduced more variety into the game. I think the cars that you play in maybe the first 50% of the game have changed more than, say, the cars at the tail end of the game. So for those people out there who have finished the game 100% and are driving the really fast kind of better cars at the end of the game, you'll notice slightly less differences. But earlier on, you'll find it's a lot easier to drive the cars. They're a lot more friendly, they crash less, and they're a lot more fun to drive for a wider audience. So that's a really good thing we've done there. We're finding that people are just having a lot more fun quicker in the game because of the changes we've made.
Cool. So that's cars. We've changed the events balancing to take that into account?
Yes. So, you know, we didn't want to make some of the cars slower and some of the cars crash kind of less and then that not be affected by the events in the game. So they've been tweaked slightly. You'll notice that it's slightly easier to make progress in the events earlier on in the game. So, you know, the new cars are more fun and easier to drive at the beginning, and the events reflect that as well. So it's generally opening it up for a broader audience to win a lot more as they're playing through the game.
And so they're not the only changes we've made to the events. We changed Stunt Run.
Stunt Run again, similar thinking. If people are really, really good at Stunt Run and they're doing 40, 50, 100 combos, you know, Jez.
Every time.
You're obviously in that group. You know, they won't notice that much difference, but if you're new to the game or if you're not so good at Stunt Run, then when you start out, you'll notice that the time of pie, the amount of time you have to link your tricks together, is actually longer. So when you'll do your first air or your first barrel roll, and you'll look at the top of the screen, and you'll see that the time of pie takes now probably 15 or 16 seconds to get round the first time. If you do another trick, the time of pie takes slightly less. If you're one of those players out there that's doing, you know, 20 or 30 combos. By the time you get into the 20s or the 30s, the time of Pi will be the same time as it was before.
So not just Stunt Run change, but Road Rage as well.
Road Rage has had a tweak. As we originally shipped Paradise, for every takedown that you scored, you got time added to your score, even when you surpassed the original target for that event. So what we've done is now we've changed it so that as soon as you hit the target score for that event, so it might be you pull up to a junction and it says get 5 takedowns. When you get 6 takedowns, 7 takedowns, 8 takedowns, we always add time to your score. We've changed that so now as soon as I hit the 5 takedown limit, we stop adding time to your score. So it really is about player skill, how far you can go beyond the goal, and it's really cool.
So still, I think in the theme there of easy to pick up and tough to master.
Yeah.
So we've changed the visuals to the game. If you've played Burnout for quite a while, you'll notice that when you pick it up on the 6th, it's going to be a little bit more vibrant, a little more saturated colour. It just has that kind of brighter feel to it. We changed the way the nighttime visuals look because we found that people were having a little bit of a tough time actually seeing well enough to drive at the high speeds we have in the game.
It was a bit dark.
It was a bit dark. And we've also changed the way that some of the collectibles look. I don't know if you up to date with all that stuff, Matt?
So the billboards are certainly a lot easier to see, and the smashes are... They're much more difficult to miss.
Exactly. So they're
as
all...
being somebody who's driven around downtown for so long looking for the last
hoovering
one.
Hoovering them all up.
Oh man, that last one just took me an age. Now you're not going to miss it.
Yeah, so they're brighter colours, and you'll find that the colours pulse as well. Because we found with a lot of the collectibles, it's fun to see where they are and then work out how you get to them rather than just kind of drive around trying to find them.
Yeah.
And finally, this brings us on to the restart. So this
dun,
will be
dun, dun.
Dun, dun, dun. So if you watch the show, you'll notice we did kind of spill the Burnout beans on this one a little while ago. We did kind of hint that it was in there. We can reveal that there is a restart, and this has been something that's been a lot of people asked for it right at the start of the game. It was always hotly debated here, but I mean, what are the reasons for putting that in, Matt?
Well, you know, I think the reasons we were really firm on it right at the very start was because it didn't feel like the right thing to do. It felt like it jarred against everything else that we were trying to do in terms
of the game's open world,
being freedom and seamless, and it just felt like a real jar. But you know, we're not proud about some of these things. You know, so our pride doesn't overtake sense, and you know, lots and lots and lots of people asked for it. So, you know, I think you know, coming up to a release of the Ultimate Box, and you know, almost like the first anniversary of Paradise's debut, why not? You know, we've done so many things that we never ever envisaged doing.
Give the public what they want.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think in a game about freedom, it's kind of almost like the ultimate freedom is you can choose to play it in a very free-form way, or you can just choose to restart it and play the game quite conventionally. And that I think that's what restart gives some people. So that's about it for this week's show. I think the one thing we wanted to answer before we go was how do I get this update? Because we always get a million emails from people whenever we release an update to the game. And the answer is, if you've got Burnout Paradise and you're online and enabled, the game will patch itself. It will automatically update to include all of the stuff that we've talked about today. If you want to play Party, that's a paid-for premium content pack. You'll have to buy it through the in-game store. And if you want to play the Ultimate Box, then you need to head for a retailer now, and that's going to be the pack for you if you don't already own Burnout. So that's everything for this week, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.
Bye.
mailbag@CriterionGames.com. Mail us at Criterion Games, Onslow House, Onslow Street, Guildford, Surrey, GU1 4TN, in the UK.